Well, hey y'all, JM Real Guys Reviews. Well, I'm out at the range today with SIG Sauer's 9mm P938. Now, this is not just the 9mm version of the 238. You know, you may be thinking of that in terms of the LC9 versus LC380. They're virtually identical, except for the caliber. That's not true with this. This is a little bit bigger gun all the way around, about an ounce or so heavier, so it's a little bigger than that 380. Not much, but just a little bit. This is not considered really a micro gun. It is a pocket gun for some, a good purse gun, maybe a little bigger than some people think of with the pocket guns. You look at the finish of it, it's a beautiful 1911 variant. It has polymer grips, it has an anodized frame, obviously a steel upper, 1911 format of the little carry gun by SIG Sauer, the P938. It has some of the things that you think about with a 1911 and some that you don't. There is no grip safety. Most 1911 variants have that. This one does not. It also has a thumb safety that you expect. The thumb safety will make the trigger inactive. It does not lock down the slide like some 1911s do. It has a disconnect safety and has a firing pin safety. It also has the hammer block or hammer stop. So if you try to cock it manually, it will not be able to get to that firing pin if you slip. And as I do in all the videos, when I'm talking about these guns, I've cleared them, they're unloaded, so that I can show you the trigger and show you the different things about the gun without having to worry about that. So as I get ready to talk about the shootability of the gun, let me talk to you about one other thing. If you're new to shooting, let's say that you're a female and you want to have a gun that's really nice for your purse. Nothing wrong with this, but the 1911 formats are a little bit harder for some newcomers especially to figure out how they're going to carry them. So let me talk to you just a little bit about that. Well, Jeff Cooper, the father of modern handgun shooting, is the one that came up with the conditions of carry for guns like this. Those conditions are that we're going to be concerned with are 1, 2, and 3. Condition 1 is the normal way that most people talk about carrying a 1911 type gun. Let me show you that. It is locked and loaded, magazine obviously full, safety on, hammer back. Okay, condition 1, you get into a defensive situation, pull the gun, safety off, and you're ready to fire. Okay, you're not comfortable carrying hammer cocked, so another way you could carry is condition 2 of Jeff Cooper's, and that is locked and loaded. So once again, we've got a round in the chamber, but this time, rather than having the safety on and the hammer back, we have the safety off and the hammer down. Now, there's no decocker, so to get the hammer down, we've got to pull the trigger to get it down. That can be a little tricky, so make sure, because the firing pin safety deactivates when you pull that trigger, so it could fire. Here we are now in condition 2. Safety off, hammer down. Single action. Remember, 1911s, we're all single action, so we can't do anything with the trigger with the safety down because it's not a double action gun. Now, defensive situation, we cock the hammer, we're ready to fire. What if we try to cock the hammer and we slip? Well, our hammer block safety is going to take care of it. Plus, we also have a firing pin block safety that won't let it fire unless the trigger's pulled. Condition 3, non-locked and loaded, hammer down. There's a whole lot you've got to do in that case to get things going. One, you can say, well, I just racked the slide. The problem with that in a 1911, with the hammer down, it's not easy to rack that slide. So someone with weak wrist, weak hands may have trouble. So you may have to cock it first, then rack it. And that's a lot to do, obviously, with a round in the magazine, it'll rack back in there. But condition 3 is a little more complex. Recommendation, condition 1. Some people prefer 2. 3 is probably not the best of the ideas. All right, y'all, let's get ready to shoot it. The shootability of the gun feels great in hand. You're going to have that little pinky wrapped under, no problem. Barrel, 3 inches, makes it a little bit harder to aim, but the two big things in shootability come in now. Great sights. It has night sights, big white triple dot sights, easy to get a sight picture with. And now the all-important trigger. What most of us like about 1911s, the trigger. Triggers are usually very nice in a 1911 formatted gun. Let's see what this one's like. Okay, let's go ahead and get locked and loaded. And again, we're empty, I'll tell you otherwise. Now we're locked and loaded, hammer back. Let's take a look at this trigger. Well, it's only single action. It's not like a double action, single action, where you have to worry about two different type triggers to learn. Only one trigger to learn, it's a single action trigger. Let's take a look at it. There's the play. Just like almost all 1911s, there really is none. There's the travel and the poundage of the trigger. Might notice that's a tiny bit heavier than most 1911s. A lot of them around that 5 pound mark. This one measures by me on the Lyman trigger puller at 8 pounds. Let's do that one more time. The play, none. Take up very little at 8 pounds. Okay, locked and loaded. Condition one, carry position. Hammer back, cocked and locked, magazine with rounds. Defensive position, Federal 115 grain full metal jacket. No take up, easy to see the target with that. Nice, easy follow through with it. Wow. Minimal punch. Now there's a little punch with it, with that 9mm, but not much. It's not uncomfortable at all. As you can tell, there's no problem keeping it on target and getting back on target. You know, y'all, I think because of the short travel of this trigger and also the very short reset, it makes it seem like a lighter trigger than 8 pounds. It's certainly easier to shoot than that. Now, there is absolutely no problem staying on target with this little gun. So let's just get really nice visual of our target. Wow. And if I jerk, I'm gonna miss like anyone else. Stays open, last round fired. Tell you what, this is a pretty nice little gun. Feels good in hand. Certainly is an option for you, especially in the purse or in the cargo pants, or maybe if you have just big pockets, for a neat little carry gun from SIG. The 9mm P938. A little bit bigger than the 380 238. Not much, about an ounce or so. Very nice option for you. Hey, thanks y'all for visiting us here at Real Guys Reviews. We really appreciate it. Hope to see you around.
If you have a chance, check out our RGR video, SIG P938 Field Strip.